Hey y'all, it's your girl Kia Love. Welcome back to my channel. So this morning I'm going to start off with a fresh pressed green juice. I absolutely love green juice. It's so satisfying. This is my go-to recipe. It is my default. Yes, I do switch it up sometimes and switch out the ingredients, but for the most part, I keep this particular juice the same. I absolutely love it. It's detoxifying, it's cleansing, it's energizing, it's hydrating. So let me go ahead and give you some of these benefits. So one ingredient that I always use, no matter if I'm making this green juice or another type of juice, are cucumbers, because one, cucumbers yield a lot of juice. And then two, they're hydrating. They're hydrating and they're great for your skin. I also love to use lemons, oranges, limes, because they contain vitamin C. They're great for immune support, and lemons in particularly are great expectorants. So in case you don't know what that means, like if you have mucus buildup, that'll help get some of that mucus out. I also like to use apples in this juice as a sweetener for the juice. I don't really like super sweet juices, but the apples are like a great balance. I do have a mango here that I'm going to throw in there just because I had a mango that I needed to use. So I'm going to throw that in there, but I don't typically do that. But they're great for vitamin C as well. And I believe vitamin K, but don't quote me on that. Back to, what was I talking about? The apples? What time are the apples? Well, I'm going to talk about the apples. So like I said, they're a natural sweetener. They also have antioxidants. They clear free radicals out of your body, clear toxins out of your body. I also like to use celery because celery are great electrolytes. They're great electrolytes, and also they're great too, like after a workout, just to refuel yourself. Another great electrolyte, natural electrolyte is coconut water. So you drink some fresh coconut water. Those have electrolytes as well. Sometimes I use cilantro, sometimes I use parsley. I'll switch them up, but they're both really great. Cilantro, they rid the body of heavy metals, and parsley is great for reducing bloating, anti-inflammatory, and things like that. And ginger is always going to be in there. Ginger is bae. I call ginger my bae. I love ginger. It's anti-inflammatory. I absolutely love it. It gives a nice little kick to your drink as well. Sometimes I add beets. Beets help cleanse the blood. Sometimes I add garlic, specifically if I'm like have down with the cold or something like that. I'll throw in some garlic because garlic is a natural antibiotic, antifungal, fights viruses, also fights parasites and things like that. So garlic is very powerful. So I hope y'all try this juice out, y'all. I cannot wait to drink it. It is so satisfying and refreshing, and I love to start my day off with this.
This would make for a great Christmas gift for your significant other or a family member.
Just a quick tip. If for some reason you didn't make enough juice to fill to the top of your jar, fill it up with a little bit of spring water like I did here, and then seal it tight with an airtight lid. This is particularly important if you're not going to drink your juice right away, because as oxygen gets to the juice, it starts to oxidize, the nutrients start to disappear, become less effective and less powerful, and you definitely want to slow down that process. So we want to get the most impact that we can, so fill it up to the very top.
Thank you.
So it's been about an hour or two since I drank my green juice, and I like to wait at least a minimum of 30 minutes before you're eating anything after drinking a green juice, but I prefer to do 2 hours. So now I'm going to pick up on what I like to call my breakfast part two, but just for the sake of it, I'll call it a snack. So I'm going to eat the rest of this watermelon that I have. I have half of a watermelon and half of a papaya that I need to eat. So I'm going to go ahead and chop this up and continue to fill my body with this delicious goodness. So it's dinner time and I decided I wanted to try to make a vegan hamburger helper. And yes, I'm going to attempt to make it. I have never made it before, so I'm going to be winging it as I go. I'm sauteing up some onions and now I'm grabbing some vegan ground beef from my freezer. This is my homemade vegan ground beef recipe, my ground beef crumble. If you haven't checked out that recipe, it's in the link in the description box below. And I'm going to add a little bit of tomato sauce to the pan. One thing I love about my vegan ground beef is that it's great for easy meal nights. I literally took it out the freezer and I'm using it. It's super easy to prep. I am now adding some coconut aminos. You could also add vegan Worcestershire if you have some. I'm going to season it up with a little bit of thyme. And then I'm going to add a little bit of onion powder, followed by some garlic powder. Some chili powder, smoked paprika, and then I'm just going to mix this up. Like I said, I haven't made this before. I am trying to make the original hamburger helper recipe, meaning the one with the elbows and the hamburger. I know they have different types, but I'm just trying to make the original recipe. Like I said, I haven't made this before, y'all, so I'm just winging it, man. This is how it goes on a regular day. So y'all are just with me on my what I eat in the day. This is what I do. And here it is. Let's give it a try. Let's see how this turned out. Okay, so now that my ground beef is done, I went ahead and sprayed the pan with some nonstick spray because I want to use the same pan for the flavor. I took some of my vegan mac and cheese out the freezer. If you haven't checked out my vegan mac and cheese recipe, the link is in the description box below. I did defrost it earlier in some warm water, so now I'm just warming it up in the pan. And as you can see, it's still nice and cheesy. So I'm just warming it up, and now I'm going to throw a little bit of my meat sauce on top, and now I'm just going to see how this all turns out. So my hamburger helper is done and I want to eat a side of sauteed greens with this. So here I have a tub of organic super greens. It has baby kale, baby spinach, baby mizuna, Swiss chard, all of that good stuff. I added a little bit of olive oil to the pan, but you don't have to use olive oil. You can just use water to saute this. Sauteing greens are so simple and it's so quick. I'm going to keep this simple and I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of pink salt. I squeeze a little bit of lemon juice, and I may add a little bit of minced garlic. I'm not sure yet. We'll see how I feel, but I'm going to saute this up, and then let's see how this all turns out. So is it just me? Am I the only one that is surprised every time these greens shrink? It's like I use this entire tub of greens and it looks like a lot when I first started off. But then when I saute it, it shrinks to almost nothing. It's crazy, man. So anyways, I'm going to finish off these greens and then we're going to plate it and see how this all turned out. Okay, y'all, so I'm so excited to try this vegan hamburger helper. I know it looks like slop right now. I know you're probably side-eyeing it, but I'm telling you, it's going to be good. It does have texture. I used elbow noodles in my mac and cheese, so it does have texture. And I know you can't really tell, but it's going to be good. So I topped it off with a little more of the meat sauce that I made, and I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of parsley. Got to add some greenery to it. And of course, I have to add some fresh chopped tomatoes. I just couldn't help myself. If you don't know, I love fresh tomatoes. So adding those to the top, I think it's going to add some nice freshness to this meal. And then last but not least, the sauteed greens. I can't believe. Look at this, y'all. Look at this. That whole tub that I used. Look how little bit of greens. There's nothing left in the pan, y'all. Look at that. But anyways, y'all, this is how it turned out, the vegan hamburger helper. I hope you enjoyed it, y'all. In case you wanted to know, this did turn out really good. I would definitely make it again. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to get notified whenever I post, hit that bell icon and the subscribe button. And until next time, y'all, peace and love.